we've just completed this DVD where we're looking at Dave Grohl's drumming on going back to his days with Nirvana, a couple of tracks from Queens of the Stone Age, as well as the Foo Fighters as well. And we're taking a look at his playing on the tracks and breaking the parts down, so looking at how to play the fills and the grooves and then bringing it all back together with performances of the tracks as well. I think Dave's such an influential drummer because he's sort of the new John Bonham in a lot of people's eyes, because he combines the musicality and playing for the song aspect of John Bonham's playing, but I think it's with the sense of power that a lot of the rock and metal players have these days. And so I think it's that style of drumming has just connected with a new generation of players, really. I think my favourite track has to be Song for the Deaf. I think it's great to hear Dave playing what's essentially a drum solo at the beginning of that track. And there's some great drumming on all the tracks that we've chosen here, but I think that really gives you a good insight into his playing. It took me a while to learn to play the tracks, actually. A track like Song for the Deaf, it's quite a long tune, and there's obviously various fills and different elements to get to grips with as well. And it's one thing being able to play the individual parts, but to play the whole track as a performance, as per the original recording, is really quite a challenge, really. And I think in some respects it's easy to dismiss certain things that Dave does as relatively simple, but when you've got it in context with the whole 5-minute tune and you have to play it completely accurately, I think it is a real challenge for any drummer, really. So the tracks that we've chosen offer varying degrees of difficulty, really. So a track like Teen Spirit is probably reasonably easy to get to grips with once you've got the basic parts that run through it. But a tune like perhaps Song for the Dead or No One Knows, it may take you a little longer to get to grips with, but I'm sure with a bit of work, a lot of those fills will start to creep into your own playing, and you'll be able to use them freely on your own in your own music as well. I think this is a great DVD because it's, whether you're a fan of Dave Grohl or just a fan of rock drumming generally, you're going to get a lot out of this, both in terms of learning the parts that Dave plays on those tracks in particular, but it's also going to expand your repertoires as a rock drummer generally, both in terms of fills and groove ideas.